Hi, Brian here. Video about the blender that I built. It's got a phase inverter for the send. So if ever you have a pedal that's out of phase with your dry signal, you can flip it and bring it back in phase. There's a couple cool things you can do with it, and I'll go through those now. So turning it on gives you an effects loop that you can blend in parallel with your dry signal. So it's in phase now, running. I'll bring the pedal in that's in the loop, but just to show you the phase inverter. So it's going through a true bypass pedal right now, in phase, and if I throw it out of phase, you can probably hear my guitar more than you can the signal of the. Then if I bring that back in phase, okay, now the pedal that I've got in the effects loop of the blender is the Tailspin Vibrato by TC Electronic. And now this pedal is out of phase with your dry signal, so I'll demonstrate that quickly. The blender is in phase, going through true bypass through this pedal, so unaffected. Now if I turn on the Tailspin, it works, but the low end is kind of gone. So that indicates that you need to put it out of phase and the low end comes back. I'll just hammer on the E chord, put it back out of phase. So there you go. Now you can take it full dry or full wet, which gives you only vibrato. Full dry, which completely bypasses this. Or anywhere in between, and that'll give you like a makeshift chorus. That's probably a little too exaggerated there. There you go. All right, now I've got a Tube Screamer Mini, just a classic overdrive in the effects loop that you can blend in parallel. Oops, so that's out of phase. Bring it back in phase. And now this is with the overdrive in parallel with your dry. Halfway blended between wet and dry. And you can take that full wet, which is only sending your signal through the Tube Screamer. That blend a little bit more dry in. Or have hardly. Just color it a little bit. Alrighty, so last kind of cool thing you can do is take a like iPad, phone, or whatever music, send it to the return, and then you can blend the music into your dry signal through your amp and jam with songs. So that's my signal, and then I can jam along with music. Thank you. you get the idea. That's pretty cool. Only bad thing about it is, since it is a TRS jack, you only get the tip that goes through, so either the left or right ear. Maybe I'll mod this one day so that you can have both channels mix back in with like another external switch or something like that. Both channels mix into one mono. But it is still pretty fun to jam out with different music. One other thing I want to mention about this blend pedal is that I can't demonstrate because I don't have any pedals that digitize the entire signal, but it is very useful for those types of pedals, such as a like a Line 6 DL4. They don't split the signal like this pitchfork, for example. Your signal goes in and then is split, leaving the dry analog all the way through, and then one of the split signals gets digitized through a DAC or an ADC, and then it, you know, the chip works its magic, and then they get blended back together analog out. So it goes in, split, ADC back to the DAC to digital analog converter, and then everything goes back out mono. But like a Line 6 DL4, or I think some POG models, your signal will go in and the entire thing will get digitized. I know the like the new Canyon delay does that as well. So it goes in, the entire thing gets digitized, and then it goes back out analog, of course. But what's useful for that, like especially the Canyon delay, is you can bring it, you can turn it on full wet and then put it in the loop of this, and your analog signal stays dry. Now, I'm probably a analog snob because I've paid close attention to make sure my entire analog or my entire dry signal stays analog in my entire board. That might not be important to all people, but to me it very much is. So this pedal is definitely useful for that. Alrighty, so that's my blender. Thanks for watching. Have a good one.